We often get asked, what is the best telescope for beginners? Our team has put together a list of attributes that a telescope must have to gain the title the best telescope for beginners. So here in a moment, we will tell you exactly what telescope this is. I'm Tegan with High Point. Thank you for joining and stay tuned. All right, so let's talk about all of these attributes that the best telescope for beginners must possess. First and foremost, it must be able to see details on the lunar surface, planets, and deep sky objects. Secondly, it must be portable or at least semi-portable. Thirdly, it must have high-quality diffraction-limited optics. And fourth and finally, it must check as many boxes as possible for somebody who wants to view the wonders of the night sky. And with all that being said, the single best telescope for beginners is... Okay, I'm coming. Hello, Tegan with...
I don't know how many times I have to tell you. Again, it's the Apertura AD8. You got it? The Apertura AD8.
It's the Apertura AD8. This telescope is capable of viewing every popular celestial body from the Moon, the planets, Orion's Nebula, all the way to galaxy groups such as the Leo Triplet. So let's talk about the first attribute that we mentioned. This telescope must be able to view details on the Moon, the planets, and deep sky objects. The Apertura AD8 has not only the capable magnification limits to view the Moon in its entirety, but to view the Moon in sections. As you peer through the eyepiece at high magnifications, the craters will resemble mountains on a light gray background, with their shadows from the setting sun being cast on to the smooth lava fields around them. Brighter galaxies can be seen with their spiral structure apparent, and star clusters with their hundreds of stars resolved. When you pick up Apertura's 70-degree field of view eyepieces, it makes this viewing experience incredibly immersive. The Apertura 88 8-inch mirror is a light bucket and is capable of achieving these kind of views. The build quality of the 88 stands alone in its class with its flawless alt-azimuth movements and its high precision adjustment capabilities. These traits are coupled with portability, the second attribute that a telescope must have in order to be titled as the best telescope for beginners. You are in fact able to travel with this scope in the back of your sedan, and the optional Apertura carrying case makes this a lot easier. The third attribute, and arguably the most important, the best telescope for beginners must have high quality diffraction limited optics. You do not want the optics of your telescope to be the limiting factor in the quality of your views. Another way to put this is that you want to know with confidence that when the skies are clear, you're going to be able to maximize every minute you have out under the night sky. You do not want the optics to hold you back, and with the Apertura 88, that will not be the case. So the fourth and final attribute that the best telescope for beginners should have is that it checks as many possible boxes for somebody looking to view the wonders of the night sky. And by check as many boxes as possible, what we mean is, can you upgrade this in the future? Can you use a wide variety of accessories? Is there positive community feedback surrounding this telescope? Does it have a good warranty? Is it portable or semi-portable? And finally, does it have the capabilities of taking very basic astrophotography pictures? Well, it just so happens that the 88 does in fact check all of these boxes. All of the things that we talked about in this video make the Apertura 88 the single best telescope for beginners. 8-inch Dobsonians are a classic choice not only for beginner amateur astronomers, but also intermediate and advanced amateur astronomers. The Apertura 88 is just one that stands above the rest in its class in both quality and in support. All right, so that is it. Thank you so much for tuning in to our video on the best telescope for beginners. If you have any questions at all, please let us know in the comments and we'll be more than happy to assist. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any future content over all things astronomy and astrophotography. Thank you so much, and clear skies.